What's up, space pirates? In today's video, we're going to check out Green Strawberry's hangars for the USS Defiant in 1/4-20 scale. Before we get into the video, let's see. One instruction manual, one set of water slide decals, one sheet of photo etch, 15 pieces of resin. Resin craft include two worker bees, two type 18, and one type 10 shuttle. And the kit retails for $45.94 US plus shipping. So we took a look at what's in the box. Now let's jump into the box. We'll start off with the instruction sheet. At the top, it tells you the kit number and it shows you all the parts in the box. It also shows you where you have to take off the resin, and that's all marked in red. So this way you're not making any mistakes. Goes into the key here to show you what the callouts are from Green Strawberry while you're doing your work, and then it goes into the instructions. The instructions are pretty clear except for a few parts. This is single here, as you can see, just single parts, what you to do, and then it goes into the rest of the build. Now, what I was talking about jumbled up is like in number two, you have two different parts going on here. This is for the main bay, and then you got the chaffee, and the numbers are kind of congested, so you can get a little confused as what's going on. And then it goes into the single parts, which is fine. Over here, be a little careful of what you're doing. You're going from left to right looking at it, but things are a little jumbled up over here. And the last one is number 10, that's jumbled up a little bit. You have two ships going on at the same time with the numbers very close to each other. So just make sure you're putting the right decals in the right parts. If they would have added one more sheet in here, they could have spread that out a little bit better and made the instructions just a little more clear for you guys. Next up, we'll take a look at the water slide decals. I haven't really seen any of these from Green Strawberry, but these are very, very nice. There's not a lot of carrier film. I don't know if you can see that. The only place I saw a lot of carrier film, and it's going to happen, is around the registration numbers, the NCC numbers, but they're not going to be able to get that small. They are very well saturated. The color is nice and saturated. You have extra decals for parts of the ship just to give that little extra detail. These are for the side hangar bays, and this is for the main hangar bay right here. Everything's nice and clear, and it'll enhance the build a little bit more than what you already have going on. Next up, we're going to take a look at the photo etch sheet. I'm sorry about the glare. I'm just trying to get it so that you can see it here. It's going to come with the two roll down doors for the hangar bays, open shuttle doors for the side hangar bays, the main hangar bay detail. This goes around the ring inside. And then you also have ladders and the guards for the ladders. And those are just in case somebody's going to fall. Hopefully they can grab onto that. They are nicely detailed. There's not really a lot of detail because it's a lot of flat surfaces, but it will enhance the build that much more, especially with like the little grid lines on the closed doors here. You'll be able to throw a wash in there and bring those out. And the ladders, if you look at the pictures, are pretty cool. Up next, we're going to go through the resin parts for the shuttle bays. This is the back wall. You can see like the windows here and then the door opening down there. So this is nice and clean. Down here is your pour stub. They use excellent resin for all of their kits. You just got to be careful cutting that off. You don't want it to go all wonky and sideways on you. The previous part was the back wall to the next two sections I'm going to show you. This is the interior where you're going to add the ladders. It's got some interior detail. This is the main shuttle bay for the kit. And you can see over there the nice detail. So this is going to be actually the top portion of the kit. And that wall, once you cut off, now this is a big chunk right here of the resin that has to be cut off. So you got to kind of cut this in a curve. Just make sure you're careful cutting that because it will get thin on you and you don't want to break that over there. This is the same part of the shuttle bay, except this is the top half. And it pretty much has the same detail on the inside where you add the ladders. The only difference is this doesn't get cut off. This is actually part of the shuttle bay that goes on the top. I would put them together, but this also has the big pour stub over here that I haven't taken off, otherwise we would put them together. And then another part to this is the little round circle over here. Once you cut this pour stub off, it will go right into over here. And again, nice detail on here. You can see the lines and everything on the inside. A nice job on the shuttle bay. This part will be cut off right here. You're going to cut the pour stub off over here. And that's going to go onto the top of the other piece that I showed you first. This is also for the shuttle bay, all these parts right here. If they're not for the shuttle bay, I'll let you know. This is the last part for the shuttle bay. I'm trying not to get my fingers in the way for you. This is a railing for the inside. It's very thin and delicate, so you got to be careful. Hopefully when the postman sends it, it doesn't get broken on you. As you can see, there's some warp at the end here, but that's no big deal. That could be taken care of. The problem with mine is there's actually a warp right in the direct center. So I don't know if heat will take care of that and get it back into position. I searched it online and found that this should be even all the way around without a warp in it. And also looking at Green Strawberry site, this doesn't have a warp in it. It should be just straight around. So hopefully that'll come out, and hopefully yours comes out straight instead of having a warp right here in the middle. These two pieces are the same. They're just inserts for the side shuttle bays. They'll get more detail with a couple other resin parts and also photo etch. So these just pop on there. You'll actually be taking the back portion out over there, cutting that out. Here's the pour stub over here. You cut that out and it'll be open, and then you can put that in there. And I'm pretty sure these are the ones you can have in the open or closed position with the photo etch that comes with the kit. These two pieces are also for the side shuttle bays. It goes with this piece over here. Just follow the directions and it'll show you where it goes. A little bit of detail added. It's like little ramps over here that add onto it, and you got your pour stub here that you'll cut off. Again, just be careful because they are pretty close to the pour stubs. And these are the last pieces of those side shuttle bays, windows for the, I think it's the interior of it. And again, two pieces for either side of the ship, and you got your pour stub down here that has to be cut off. This way you can get the piece on there nice and clean. Now the kit comes with 5 spacecraft along with it. These are the worker bees, and they're very, very tiny. So you have to follow the directions on those to paint them. I mean, it's having real trouble keeping these guys in focus, but you get the 2 worker bees with these guys that you could put in the set. I would try to flip them around, but let me see if I could keep it in focus. See how small they are? You can't even see these guys barely on camera, even if I take my hands out of the way. This is crazy, the size of 420 scale little worker bees, but you do get 2 worker bees with it. The set also comes with 2 Type 18 shuttles, which are bigger than the worker bees and will be a little bit more easy to work on. You still need your magnifiers on these, but here you can see the profile of them. You can see them from the nose going on down. The other profile and the rear. They're cast really well for a very small ship. These you definitely got to be careful. If you can see, the pour stub is right at the bottom. It looks like there's some hash marks on there. This way you can see where to cut those shuttles off. And the last shuttle it comes with is the Type 10 Chaffee, and this is the side view of it. This one's definitely bigger. This one's made for the main hull. You can see, I mean the main hangar bay. This is the top view of it. And then if I flip it around, you can see the engines of it. And here's the bottom, very nicely done. The casting point or the cut point is at the front, so you don't have to worry about taking off the pour stub. It's actually easy enough to cut that off there and then just clean it up. All right, let's get into the pros and cons of this kit. First, we'll go with the cons. The first thing they should have done with the instructions is separated those parts instead of having multiple sections in one area. Make it easier for you, the reader, to read. Con number 2 is this is a dead kit or a rare kit, because the molds for this kit was broken. I think it was back in 2017, and this kit won't be made anymore in this scale, 420. It's in 1/1000 scale. 420 scale is very expensive, and I'm not going to go out to buy it. If they would have put their money maybe into something else that's newer or more readily available, that would have been a better choice in my opinion. Con number 3. Warped resin. That warp in that one piece, the railing, that may be a little bit of a problem for me to get out because of how it is warped. It's more in a down and an up instead of just a little curvature down where I could have got it up. But even with those 3 cons, it's still a good kit. It's not a deal breaker. It's just nitpicky stuff that's in the kit and can be fixed, except for doing a kit for an out of production kit. Now for the pros of this kit. I know I said it was a con, but it's also a pro that Green Strawberry made a 420 scale aftermarket set for this kit, because a lot of people out there do have the kit, so it'll help them out, but it's definitely not helping out anybody in the future that's going to try to buy this kit or not buy this kit, whichever way you want to look at it. Next pro is excellent decals. The decals came out really well. They got very little carrier film on them. The color is saturated very well, so they'll show up really nice on your build. 2 worker bees and 2 shuttles. That is an excellent thing to have in the kit. Instead of having just one worker bee and one shuttle, it gives you more options to use either the two worker bees or the two shuttles in a different array that you want to use them. The next pro is excellent PE. Green Strawberry is known for their PE and the detail that they put in it, and this is no exception for what they did with the PE set here. So that's a big pro. And also a pro is the Type 10 Chaffee. Haven't seen one of those yet. So them to make the chaffee that comes with the kit is an excellent, excellent deal. You can put that into the hangar bay, or you can actually probably put a little thin rod on it and have it next to the ship, outside the ship. So that would look pretty cool. And the last pro, always with Green Strawberry, they have excellent casting. There's usually no bubbles. They use high quality resin and their pieces come out very nicely. Sometimes you do have the odd piece that has a bubble in it, or like my piece was warped, but hopefully, like I said before, mine can be fixed. If you're interested in this product or any other products by Green Strawberry, please visit their site at greenstrawberry.cz. The link will be in the description below. And if you're interested in more pictures, please follow the link in the description below. That'll bring you to the written review. And there's a ton of pictures in there of all the pieces in this product. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit the little bell as well. This way you can catch all videos from us and our live streams. Thanks for stopping by. Take care and bye-bye.